Hello, everyone viewing us from wherever you are. You are once again most welcome to Standard High School Zana, a virtual classroom. My name is Jonas Gumiserza, Department of Economics here at Standard High School Zana. In the previous episode, dear viewers, we looked at factors that influence credit creation. We looked at factors that limit the process of credit creation, whereas the factors that favor the process of credit creation. Now we want to look at another concept, which is the assets and liabilities of a commercial bank. When we talk of assets of a commercial bank, we mean the possessions of a commercial bank plus the claims against other institutions and customers. What the commercial bank possesses and what it claims on other institutions and customers is what we call the assets of a commercial bank. In other words, what a commercial bank owns, and they include cash in form of notes and coins, or cash and all bank notes and coins in the bank are part of its assets. Also, deposits with other banks. You know, a bank like Centenary Bank can make deposits in, let's say, Stanbic Bank. Also, that is an asset, because Centenary Bank will be possessing that money. Then, loans and advances. When a bank gives you a loan, now it has a claim on that. And you remember we said assets are possessions and claims on other institutions and customers. So loans advanced to the customers are also part of the bank assets. Also, securities in form of treasury bills bought by the bank. If a bank buys the treasury bills from the government, now that is also an asset. It is a possession of the bank. Then the special deposits with the central bank. You know, a commercial bank may make a special deposit above the legal reserve requirement. You know, the law says that a commercial bank must keep a certain amount of money with the central bank. That is the legal reserve requirement. So the special deposit is that amount which is over and above the legal reserve requirement. Then the reserves of the bank with the central bank, if a commercial bank has got reserves, excess reserves, and decides to keep some with the central bank, all those are assets of the bank. Then we also have long-term investments in other institutions. A commercial bank may make an investment, let's say NSSF. That is also an asset of a commercial bank. Then we also have fixed assets owned by the bank, like land, buildings, vehicles. All those are assets of a commercial bank. Bearing in mind that the assets of a commercial bank, we mean the possessions of the bank plus the claims on other institutions and the customers. So those are the assets of commercial banks. Then we also have to look at liabilities. What are liabilities of a commercial bank? The liabilities of a commercial bank, dear viewers, we mean the claims against a commercial bank by creditors, or what a bank owes to other banks and non-bank institutions like the customers. Those are what we call liabilities of a commercial bank. The claims on the bank now. In the assets, it is claiming on other institutions, but in liabilities now, other institutions have claims on the bank. That's what we call liabilities of the bank. And they include, number one, the capital contributed by the shareholders. Capital contributed. When shareholders of the bank contribute capital, now it is the obligation of the bank to make sure that that capital at a certain time is paid back. Because the shareholders, for them, they keep demanding the what? The bank. They keep claiming only the bank. Okay? So, we also have reserves payable to the central bank. When you find that the bank is supposed to take some reserves to the central bank, but they have not yet taken it there. So, it is still payable. Reserves payable. It is also another liability of commercial bank. Then also, customers' deposits. When customers bring their money to the bank, they now have a claim over it. So you as a bank, you have obligation of keeping the customers' deposits, because one time they will come to claim it. Bearing in mind that when we talk of liabilities, we mean the claims on the bank by the outsiders, in other words. Then we also have dividends payable. Dividends payable. Shareholders are supposed to get dividends. But the year has ended, the dividends have not yet been received by the shareholders. So they remain payable. It is also a liability of a commercial bank. Because the shareholders, they are entitled to dividends, but the bank, because of one reason or the other, they have not yet paid the dividends, and they remain outstanding. It is also a liability of the commercial bank. Then deposits in the bank by other banks. Deposits in the bank by other banks. Like the example we earlier looked at of Centenary taking deposits in Stanbic Bank. For Centenary, it is an asset. But for Stanbic Bank, it is a liability. Because Centenary Bank claims that money in Stanbic Bank. So money deposited by other banks is also a liability of a bank. Then money borrowed from the central bank. Money borrowed from the central bank. We shall see in the functions of the central bank that the central bank is a lender of the last resort, meaning that the commercial banks sometimes go to the central bank to borrow. So that money a commercial bank borrows from the central bank is also a liability. Then also the government funds deposited in the bank. If the government of Uganda deposits money in a given bank, it becomes a liability of that bank. So, dear viewers, those are assets and liabilities of a commercial bank. Knowing that when we talk of assets, we mean the possession of the bank and what it claims on other institutions and customers. Then when we talk of liability, we mean the claims on the bank by the outsiders. So, after looking at that, dear viewers and students in particular, we have to look at the dilemma. The dilemma. We talk of dilemma. When somebody is in a dilemma, it means he or she is confused. So we are looking at dilemma facing commercial banks in their lending policy. Because we find that these commercial banks must fulfill three objectives of profitability, liquidity, and security. There is always a dilemma in commercial banks' lending policy in regard to achieving the objectives of profitability, liquidity, and security simultaneously. These objectives are hard to achieve at the same time, or which we have called simultaneously. So you find the commercial bank is in the dilemma. Because you will find that if a commercial bank tries to make more profits by lending more money to the public, they affect liquidity. Because much of the money is lent out in order to earn profits, which means they affect liquidity. If it tries to maintain high level of liquidity in order to fulfill the liquidity objective, it will lend less money into the saturation and it will not make profits. And if again it tries to lend more money in order to earn profits, they are affecting security objective, because in doing so, they even lend money to customers who are uncreditworthy. So the commercial bank is always faced with a dilemma of achieving the three objectives simultaneously: the profitability, liquidity, and security objectives. So we are going to look at how do these commercial banks try to make sure that the three objectives are achieved. So we shall begin by looking at how a commercial bank maximizes profitability objective. Or let's begin with liquidity. Because we have seen that it is a dilemma in their lending policy to ensure that they are liquidity and profitability and security objectives. So the bank must look for ways of to make sure that the three objectives are achieved. Let's see how liquidity is achieved. Number one, by maintaining a cash ratio. Because we said in the process of credit creation that the bank must retain a cash ratio to cater for the day-to-day demands of the customers. And those day-to-day demands of the customers are what we call liquidity. So they do that by maintaining a cash ratio.